Hey, what's up, guys? This is Mario back again with another YouTube video. Today's video, I'm going to talk about how you're able to play Ethermon on Decentraland. At the moment, most battle scenes are at the Ethermon website. It is in 2D, but you can actually take your Ethermon from the Ethermon website to Decentraland in a 3D world, and you could also battle them and also participate in different activities. So what I'm also going to cover is how to keep up with what the events are happening, what is going on within the Ethermon world, the Decentraland world, and where to get that information. As a new trainer, as a new Ethermon collector, sometimes if you don't know what's going on, you do feel lost, but I'm gonna show you guys how to keep up with everything, where to access that information, where to ask questions, so you're able to build your characters and participate in the free giveaways, like free NFTs, free Ethermon characters, and things like that, guys. So if you have any questions, feel free to ask me down below in the YouTube comments. Don't forget to smash that like button and subscribe down below to this YouTube channel. Let me share my screen and let's get started, okay? All right, guys. So what I'm gonna do, guys, I am gonna share my screen and then I'm gonna show you guys what you guys need to do to keep up with this. So this is the website, Ethermon. So a lot of people who are new to this and signed up for this, of course, you do need to log into your MetaMask. I'm already logged in. And once you log in, you click once you log into your MetaMask, you click on login here in the Ethermon website. And of course, click on log into your MetaMask. I mean, log into Ethermon website using the MetaMask account. Once you've done that, the next thing you want to do to play the 3D battle in the Decentraland is actually to go to here, to go to 3D battle in the wild. So there's six examples right now. The one that I recommend is actually to kind of get started is actually example number one. That's the one that's kind of feel like it's fully already created. And once you do that, of course you want to get logged in. Decentraland already recognized my browser because I've already logged in several times already. So we're just waiting for that to log in. Meanwhile, we're waiting for that to log in. I also want to kind of go over where you could access information, where you could keep up with what's happening in the Ethermon world. And that's going to be through the blog. Now, there are several activities happening at the moment in the Ethermon world. And this is where you pretty much keep up with everything. So for example, as of now, and again, this was actually posted today. Today is May 25th. There was, of course, Ethermon announces silver ticket contests, NFT rewards. So right now they pretty much have a contest that if you collect silver tickets, you may be able to give they will give a what's called electric giveaway. So this is an NFT, this is an Ethermon, again, the former NFT. So if you click on this article, it pretty much will give you step-by-step instructions on how to do that. So this is right here. Welcome to all new trainers who have joined Ethermon community over the last few weeks. Our Emon token launch was an incredible 2-week long event where we managed to expand our community by more than 5 times. There now exists more than 125,000 mons, again, short for Ethermon, and over 50,000 players. That's pretty awesome. During the IDO process, we introduced the Decentraland Dig event to give an additional opportunity for our community to whitelist. The rules were simple. Bring your mom to the Decentraland, tell them to dig. And if you were lucky enough to find golden tickets, the whitelist entry was yours. Now, first elected silver ticket reward, throughout the IDO event, you were able to find silver tickets by defeating slimes in battle while in the Decentraland. On May 26th, we will be randomly selecting 5 silver ticket holders to distribute electrics, which are $350 value each. The drawing for these winners will be broadcasted live in our weekly community call in Discord Wednesday at 1 p.m. Central. So that's the other thing, guys. The other place, so actually let me go back to the Decentraland now that I'm logged in. This is pretty much how it looks like, guys. This is the place where you can start pretty much battling. You could battle your Ethermon and things like that. Now, this is pretty much to find your Ethermon. I already kind of went through the process. Mine is right here. I actually put it to sleep right here. This is Kyrie. I put it to sleep because it ran out of energy. So right now it's still sleeping. It needs more, 9 more hours. So pretty much every day, once you battle it, you want to put it to sleep so it can kind of recharge itself. So right now it's asleep. So I gotta wait once it wakes up, so I'm able to battle it or dig for silver tickets. So once it's awake, all you have to do if you want to battle is just click any of these any of these Ethermon. And once you click on them, a little sign is gonna say battle and see attack. You click on attack and you're able to pretty much battle them. Hey, actually my Ethermon, I think, looked like it woke up. Actually, it looks like they're battling. He's battling my Ethermon, and right now it's sleeping. So this Ethermon is literally beating up my Ethermon while it's asleep. Now I did click battle, so attack, excuse me. So because it's attacked, it started to like literally fight in it. So wait a minute, I think my Ethermon. No, it's still sleeping. So it's still sleeping. So I'm gonna let it sleep. So. Because I can't really use it. I can't really do anything until it wakes up. So once it wakes up, again, I'm able to pick up things and things like that. Now, this is another thing. You could also, you know, farm and plant seeds and garden. And the way you do that is, and actually right here, I got this big carrot, which I could actually give it to my Ethermon, and it should be able to give it energy. So let me give it to my Ethermon right here. Where's Kyrie? Where are you? Where'd you go? Oh, there they are. There he is. So I'm going to go to this character and I'm going to give him, oh, where did he go? Yeah, he tends to kind of move a lot. So not sure what happened. Oh, let me press cancel on that. So I think I'm just going to have to give it to a random one. But anyways, that carrot, you give it to your Ethermon and it eats it and it gives them energy. Now, if I want to garden something up, I just click on the garden. And right now, some of the stuff that my Ethermon found in the ground when I told it to dig was like, there was this cucumber seeds. We have beetle seeds, beet seeds, and carrot seeds. I'm going to plant a cucumber seed, see what this does. So once it press to plant a cucumber seed, it does say that it's going to take 1 minute and 56 seconds for that to kind of finish up. Once that's done, again, I'm able to give that to my Ethermon, and my Ethermon should be able to eat it and get some energy from that. Now, let me see. Okay, that is definitely still sleeping, so I'm going to let it sleep. Anyways, I want to go back to the blog. So the other place where if you have a lot of questions and you want to get in something, you want to get in contact with someone, you want to go to Discord. Discord is the place. And here it is. Here it popped up on me. So that's good. Discord is a place. And I already kind of signed up already. But Discord is a place where you can ask people. It is a community rated gaming community. So you can ask people. There's a general chat. And you could meet other people, meet other friends, other collectors, other trainers who are trainers in the Ethermon world. But you could also ask questions, you know, and there's actually several languages, actually, because Ethermon is international. There's Japanese, Chinese, Vietnamese, and Spanish. But there's also, you could ask questions. And actually here, there's a channel for giveaways. But you could ask questions. These are the Ethermon team. You could send them a message directly. Or actually, there's a monitor right here. You guys can questions. Hey, I have questions about this. I'm not sure how this works. Can you help me out? So this is a place where you want to come on Discord and ask some questions. Now, let me go back to the central line. Yep, here it is. My crop is finally done. Let me pick it up. Actually, where is it? Let me pick it up. Oh, it's actually almost done. Hold on. It's 14 more seconds and it's done. And while that finishes, I also want to mention that you could actually buy eggs, Ethermon eggs. And actually this is an egg nest right here. If you click on it, this thing will pop up. And pretty much if you buy this egg, which is, it's 1,000, I believe this is mana. Let me see. Let me double check. It's loading up. Yes, it's actually, yeah, 1,000 mana. This is 1,000 mana, which is 0.46 Ethereum. And actually, that's how much the gas fee is, which is pretty insane. So I'm definitely not paying that gas fee. But, you know, total 1,000 mana plus a gas fee, we're looking at around $2,000. So definitely not interested in this. It's way too expensive. But that's something that you could do if you are interested in buying it. But if you do buy this, this egg, once it hatches, it pretty much gives you a 25% probability you could get this one, 30% probability you get this, 25% you get a Durantu, and 20% you get a Finray. So these are all very rare Ethermon characters that you could get if you were to buy this egg and once it hatches. All right, so it looks like my cucumber is ready. Let me pick it up. Pick it up so you can see I've already picked it up. Let me see. Yeah, you guys can see right there. Let me see if I can give it to my Ethermon. Where's Kyrie? There you are. He's sleeping right now, so I'm going to give it to him. All right, let me see. Where are you? Where are you? So he kind of just moves around. And actually, he looks like he's digging on his sleep. So I find that very interesting. So that's pretty much it, guys. I hope this kind of makes sense, guys. I know being new to the Ethermon world can be confusing, guys. That's the reason why I made this video. Again, the blog is where you can find what's currently happening, what are the events, all the questions right there. I mean, pretty much explaining step-by-step what to do is all right there. If you want to ask questions directly, Discord is the place where you can get in contact with someone. Once you join the Discord channel, you could do that, ask questions. And again, have fun, guys. I hope you guys enjoy this video. I hope you guys learned something. Don't forget to ask questions down below in the YouTube comments. And don't forget to smash that like button and subscribe to this YouTube channel. You guys will hear from me soon. Take care, guys.